Hello, I'm Michael Masters, a Michigan-based graphic designer, and I'm going to show you how to make a very simple mood board in Illustrator in just 5 steps. The process I'm going to show you goes hand in hand with this template that you can download and use to build your own custom mood board. After you watch the video, go ahead and get your free template at the link in the description below. Okay, let's dive in with step number 1, create a project folder. Okay, you might be wondering, how is a project folder going to help me create a mood board? Well, consider that a mood board is made up of an arrangement of all different design elements like photos, graphics, typography, colors, and textures. In the next step, we're going to be collecting and analyzing all of these design elements. So it just makes sense to have a specific place on our computer to store them. Here's how we do it. Let's suppose that our project is to create a logo for a small town electrician. We're going to create a new folder and give it the name of our project, Spark Electric Company Logo. Then create another folder within that project folder and give it the name Inspiration. Okay, moving on to step number 2, gather inspiration. This is where we begin to hunt for all those fantastic design elements I just mentioned. We're looking for reference images online that encompass the aesthetic and style of logo we're hoping to achieve. There are countless websites to find these images. Google Images, Pinterest, Dribbble, Behance. As we find images that inspire us, we'll save them in the inspiration folder we created in step 1. After we're satisfied with our search, it's on to step number 3, place images. Now that we have all our reference images in one place, we're going to open up that mood board template in Adobe Illustrator. We want to put our favorite and most relevant images here underneath these 3 artboards. We do that by going to File, Place, and then this dialog box pops up. Now we locate that inspiration folder, select the first image, then shift-click on the last image, and click Place. You can see our cursor is loaded with all those images. Next thing to do is click in the blank space down here and arrange the images so they're all visible. Now, since we got these online, it's likely that we'll have a mix between large, small, tall, wide, good, and bad quality images. The challenge we have now is to choose which ones we'll use and the best way to arrange them on our mood board. To make it easy, I have this quick template so we can plug in 7 images, 3 typefaces, and 5 colors very quickly. Let's start by entering the project name with the type tool. Then we'll add the images using a technique I call picture in a frame. We're going to refer to all of these images here as pictures and all of these rectangles as frames. Grab one of the pictures with the selection tool, scale and position it on top of one of the frames, then cut and paste the picture behind the frame. Control X to cut, click on the frame, Control B to paste behind. Now if I shift click on the frame, both the picture and the frame are selected. And lastly, we'll make a clipping mask to contain the picture within the frame. Once that's done, we then repeat the picture in a frame technique for every one of these images. For the typeface section, you can enter text in one of 2 ways. If you have saved images, you could use the picture in a frame technique I just showed you. Or maybe you found a font or have a font installed that complements your design already. In that case, just edit this text directly with the type tool. For the color section, there's a couple ways to do this as well. If you want to sample some colors from your images, click on one of the color swatches using the selection tool. Use the keyboard shortcut I to activate the eyedropper tool, and click on the area of the image for your color sample. Repeat that as many times as you need for all of your colors. Another option is to use Adobe Color if you want to create your own color palettes or browse through their huge collection of palettes. Once you're happy with your palette, you can easily save it to your Adobe library and it becomes immediately available in Illustrator. Then it's just a matter of clicking these swatches and selecting the color from your library. Okay, step number 4, extract the value. All right, now that you have all of your design elements in position, we're gonna do something that you really don't see on traditional mood boards. We're going to use this text underneath our pictures to briefly explain why we chose each graphic or image. Consider writing about things like the amount of detail, the boldness of colors and lines, the layout and alignment of the elements, or the proximity of elements in relation to each other. You don't need to write a novel, just list the parts that stood out to you the most. On to step number 5, print and display. The last step is the most simple, and it only has 2 parts. Print it and display it. The artboard within Illustrator is set to print out easily on letter-sized paper. I personally like to put my mood board on the wall above my monitor, so it's always within view to give your project a sense of style and direction. And there you go. There's the 5 steps on how to make a mood board in Adobe Illustrator. The goal of my channel is to help you survive and thrive in your journey as an independent artist. I'd love to have you join my tribe. All you have to do is click subscribe and ding the notification bell. If you like this video, please let me know by clicking the thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video. Toodles!